गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर रिवाइजिंग चैप्टर नंबर 2, दैट इज होल नंबर। व्हाट इज होल नंबर? द नंबर सिस्टम विच स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 0 एंड इट्स एट इनफिनिटी। ओनली पॉजिटिव नंबर्स विथ इंक्लूडिंग 0 आर नोन एज होल नंबर। सो व्हाट इज होल नंबर? दिस टॉपिक वी हैव टू डिस्कस। व्हाट इज होल नंबर? होल नंबर इज 0 प्लस पॉजिटिव नंबर। व्हाट इज पॉजिटिव नंबर? वी कैन से दैट नेचुरल नंबर। व्हाट? नेचुरल नंबर। सो होल नंबर सिस्टम विल इंक्लूड नंबर्स फ्रॉम 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 अप टू इंफिनिटी। 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 अप टू इंफिनिटी। सो दिस इज होल नंबर सिस्टम। सो फर्स्ट टॉपिक इन होल नंबर सिस्टम, होल नंबर वी हैव टू डिस्कस प्रीडेसर्स एंड सक्सेसर। व्हाट इज प्रीडेसर एंड सक्सेसर? प्रीडेसर्स मींस वी हैव टू सब्ट्रैक्ट 1 फ्रॉम द गिवन नंबर, एंड इन सक्सेसर वी हैव टू ऐड 1 इन द गिवन नंबर। सपोज 17 इज गिवन, व्हाट इज द प्रीडेसर? प्रीडेसर ऑफ 70 विल बी 3, डेसर ऑफ 17 विल बी 17 minus 1, that is 16. And what will be the successor? What will be the successor? Will be 17 plus 1, that will be 18, will be the successor. So in the case of predecessors, we subtract minus 1 from the given number, and in successor we add in the given number. But in the case of natural number, 1 doesn't have predecessors. Similarly, in the case of whole number, 0 will have not predecessors. What we have to remember here, 0 doesn't have predecessors. Means when you will subtract from 0 minus 1, it will give 0 minus 1 will be minus 1, and minus 1 is not whole number. That's why we have taken that 0 doesn't have predecessors. So you have understand predecessors and succession. Next topic is number line. We have to do addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So in the case of addition, we move from left to right. What? In the case of addition, we will move like this manner. But in the case of subtraction, we will move from right to left. And multiplication is the repetitive addition of a particular number, and division is also repetitive subtraction of a particular number. Suppose 3 multiplied by 5. 3 multiplied by 5. Either you can write as 3 plus, you write 3 as 5 times, 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3. In another way, you can write 5 plus 5 plus 5. Suppose you have to divide 12 divided by 3. So in the case of division, we have to do repetitive subtraction of the divisor, that is after division symbol that number is present. So what will be here? 12 minus 3 minus 3 minus 3 minus 3. In this manner you will get 0 as a remainder. Now see some examples. First take 2 plus 3. So, draw a line, mark 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, first is 2. Mention the 2. N plus 3 means you have to move 3 steps forward. So, 1, 2, 3, where you will reach? 5. So, 2 plus 3 will be equal to 5. Now similarly, it is given 6 minus 4. 6 minus 4. So from 6, from 0 you move 6 steps forward. So when you will move 6 steps forward, you will reach at 6. Now minus 4. So what we, when there is a minus in the, in that case you have to move from right to left. So minus 4. So move 4 steps backward. So you will reach at 2. So 6 minus 4 will be equals to 2. Now we will see example for multiplication. Take 2 multiply 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 2 multiply can be written as 2 plus 2 plus 2. What? 2 plus 2 plus 2. So you move first step 2. Where you have reached? It's 6. So 2 multiply by 3 will be equals to 6. Now in the case of division, we will take two examples. First example, in first example remainder will be 0, and in second example remainder will not be 0. So 6 divided by 2, and second I am taking 13 divided by 3. Now take 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 and 13. First we will take 6 divided by 2. So you move to first at 6. Now divided by 2 means you have to do repeated subtraction of 2. So first when you will move backward 2 steps, you will reach at 4, then 2, and finally you will reach 0. When you are reaching at 0, so in that case the remainder will be 0. If you are not reaching at 0, then in that case remainder will be not 0. How many steps you have taken to reach 0? 3. So 6 divided by 2 will be 3. Now second example is 13 divided by 3. 13 divided by 3. So your first step is to reach at 13. Now divided by 3 means you have to take 3 steps backward. So when you will take 3 steps backward, you will reach at first 10, then 7, then 4, then 1. So in this case our remainder is 1. Here what you will write, remainder is 1. Now we have to discuss the property of the whole number. So we have to discuss closure property, commutative property, associative property, distributive property and identity property. Now what closure property says, whenever we do addition, subtraction, multiplication, division of whole number, if its resultant is whole number, then for addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, closure property holds. Now, so let us take some examples. For addition we will take, let A 6 and B 5. I have taken two whole number, A equals to 6, B equals to 5. Now A plus B, that is 6 plus 5, that is 11 whole number, and 5 plus 6 also 11, that is whole number. So closure property for addition it holds. Similarly for now subtraction, for subtraction you take 6 minus 5, 1 whole number, 5 minus 6, minus 1 not whole number. So for subtraction closure property does not hold. Now let us see for multiplication. फॉर मल्टीप्लीकेशन, टेक 5 × 6 दैट इज 30, 6 × 5 30, बोथ आर होल नंबर, सो क्लोजर प्रॉपर्टी होल्ड फॉर मल्टीप्लीकेशन. सिमिलरली फॉर डिवीजन, टेक 6 / 5 दैट विल बी 1.2 दैट इज नॉट होल नंबर. सो बाय सीइंग द एग्जांपल व्हाट वी कैन से दैट, वी कैन से दैट फॉर एडिशन एंड मल्टीप्लीकेशन क्लोजर प्रॉपर्टी होल्ड, बट फॉर सब्ट्रैक्शन एंड डिवीजन इट डज नॉट होल्ड क्लोजर प्रॉपर्टी. नाउ नेक्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी इज कम्यूटेटिव प्रॉपर्टी. इन कम्यूटेटिव प्रॉपर्टी सेम like this manner we have to do. What commutative property says, when the above we are taking two whole numbers and they are, when we will change their place and they, if their resultant are same, then that is commutative, otherwise it will not be commutative. So take a equals to 5, b equals to 7. Now for addition, for addition, if a plus b equals to b plus a, then commutative property holds. So 5 plus 7, 7 plus 5, 12 equals to 12. So commutative property for addition holds. Now we will see for subtraction. For subtraction, a minus b equals to b minus a, then commutative property will hold. So let us see our statement is correct or not. 5 minus 7, 7 minus 5, minus 2 will be not equals to 2. So for subtraction it does not hold. Now similarly for multiplication, for multiplication, if a multiply b, b multiply a equals, that it will be old. So 5 multiply by 7, 7 multiply by 5, 35 equals to 35. So for multiplication commutative property holds. Now for division, if a divided by b equals to b divided by a, then it will hold, otherwise it will not hold. 5 divided by 7, 7 divided by 5, 5 upon 7 not equals to 7 upon 5. So from this example what we can say, that for addition and multiplication commutative property holds, for subtraction and division it does not hold. So for similarly for associative, for addition and multiplication it will hold. For associative property, in associative property we take 3 numbers. What? We take 3 numbers. So for addition it will be a plus b bracket plus c will be equals to a plus b plus bracket close c. And this is for addition, take any number and this statement, this equation will be correct. For similarly for multiplication, a multiply b multiply c will be equals to a multiply b multiply c. For addition it will be also applicable. Now we have to see distributive property. Now we have to see distributive property for addition and multiplication. Now suppose a multiply b plus c and a multiply b minus c. For addition and multiplication we have to see distributive property over addition and subtraction. For here addition, what will be a multiply b plus a multiply c, and here a multiply b minus a multiply c. Suppose example take 5 multiply 7 plus 5. What will be 5? 7 plus 5 into 5. 35 plus 25, that is 60. Directly you can also do 5 multiply 7 plus 5, 12, 60. Our resultant is same. Now similarly here, 5 multiply 7 minus 5, 5 multiply 7 minus 5 multiply 5, 35 minus 25, that will be equals, and when you will do directly 5 multiply by 2, that will be equals to 10. So in both case our result are same. So we have seen the distributive property over addition and subtraction. Now we will see identity. Identity property. What is identity property? Identity property says that any number you add to a given number, that doesn't affect that given number. Suppose 5 is given. 5, हमारे पास 5 है, इसमें हम कौन सा नंबर ऐड करेंगे जो हमारा रिजल्टेंट हमेशा क्या रहेगा, 5. क्या रहना चाहिए हमारा रिजल्टेंट, 5. सो सपोज वी आर एडिंग 1, इट विल गिव 6. व्हेन यू विल ऐड 2, इट विल गिव 7. सो व्हेन वी विल ऐड 0, व्हाट वी विल, व्हेन वी विल ऐड 0, 5 प्लस 0 दैट विल बी 5, 0 प्लस 0 that will be 0, 100 plus 0 will be 0. So, will be 100. Whenever we are adding 0 to a whole number, that's given whole number remains same. So, 0 will be the additive identity. So, and for multiplication, by which number we will multiply, the our product will be same as the given number. It will be 4 in the case of 1. 5 multiply 1 will be 5. 0 multiply 1 will be 0. 100 multiply 1, that will be 100. So, 0 is additive identity. What? 0 is additive identity. And 1 is multiplicative identity. What? 1 is the multiplicative identity. Now we have to see pattern. Pattern means by seeing the patterns we have to give examples. So I am taking examples that is from the book. See the suppose from example taking 96 multiplied by 5. So 96 multiply by 5 next is 96 multiply by 25, third is 96 multiply 125 we are given. Now how we will do? See 5, so we have to change into, we have to change 5, 25, 125 in 10, 100 and 1000 so that our multiplication will be very easy. Now, for changing 5 into 10, we have to multiply by 2 and to keep our result same, we have to divide also by 2. So, 96 multiply 5 multiply by 2 upon 2. So 96 multiplied 10 upon 2, 48 equals to 480. Similarly here 96 multiply, when you multiply by 4, it will become 100 upon 4, 24, so 2400. Similarly you have to multiply by 8 to become 125 to become 1000. So 96 multiply 1000 upon 8, 12, so it will be 12,000. Revise the given questions. Thank you. Have a nice day.